I'm gonna start this video today. I'm gonna start my day with a couple of unboxings. These both have just arrived. I'm gonna put this one to the side for now. And okay, this one, honestly, I have already opened it. I got too excited. I couldn't wait. I couldn't wait to turn the camera on. So I already went ahead and unboxed them. No points for guessing what's inside. What's inside the notorious black box? I love opening a new pair of Oakleys for the first time. Everything just smells so new. Everything's so clean. So I got another pair of the Oakley flight jackets. These are basically the complete white version. The complete white version to the pink ones that I've got. Does this mean I'm going to be getting rid of the pink ones? Of course not. It's just going to be another alternative. Some days I want to wear white glasses. Some days I want to wear pink. But I think the flight jackets, in terms of functionality, are some of my favorite Oakley models that have ever been produced. One problem that I received a lot with the... One problem that I get a lot with the jawbreakers is sweat buildup on the top of this frame here, and then the sweat just ends up dripping over the lenses and I can't see anything, particularly midway through a race when the temperature's quite warm. With the flight jackets, that's never been an issue. And some of the days in Ireland when I was racing the Ross, it was pretty warm, and none of the days did I get any sweat buildup on the lenses. They're really good for getting low on the bike. You get your head tucked down, you're looking up like towards the top of the glasses. There's no top frame there, so there's nothing restricting your vision. Yeah, big fan of the flight jackets, hence why I got a new pair. Again, thanks to the guys at 1080 Limited for sorting all this out. I've got to head out on the bike right now, so I've not got time to open the second package, but as soon as I get home, that's what we're gonna do. Mate, the wind. Hopefully you can hear me. The wind is absolutely insane today, so I'm just gonna have to be as careful as possible with this camera. Probably gonna keep filming to a minimum, because it's like, it's not only windy, but it's incredibly gusty as well. And like that. And I don't want a gust to catch me off guard whilst holding this camera in my hand. But yeah, we're on that pre-race ride thing again. Racing at Preston this afternoon. I think, like, hopefully the wind's gonna die down. I think it is supposed to. I think it is scheduled to die down a little bit coming this afternoon. But if it doesn't, racing on that circuit with this wind is gonna be absolutely wild. Hey Siri, what's the wind speed today?
I can't get the wind speed for the entire day, but currently it's 27 miles per hour.
27 miles per hour with 46 miles per hour gusts. I should have gone on the turbo today, really. I think that was a little bit of bad judgment on my behalf. Oh well, I'm gonna crack on. Gonna take it relatively steady, just watch myself with this wind, and then at some point I've gotta do a 15 minute tempo effort. It should be okay. I mean, it should be all right. Made it to Cedar Farm. Did a tempo effort and a couple of sprints. Managed to stay upright. I mean, if anything, it's just a decent way to test your bike handling skills. Decided that it wouldn't be the most educated or informed decision to ride along holding the camera, vlogging. But I'm gonna take shelter here for a little bit at the cafe before I head home.
The one I used yesterday.
I had 1.5 to 2 hours scheduled on my plan for today, but during that during the 15 minutes at tempo, I could feel a bit of tiredness in my legs, and combined with that outrageous wind today, I decided it would be a good idea to just cut it a little bit short, and I just did an hour. I mean, I still did the openers, the sprints, the tempo ahead of this evening, but I just cut that duration down a little bit. I think the new Oakleys look so sick, especially with the St. Piran team kit. It's a perfect contrast to the black, and yeah, really happy with them. Anyway, as I said before, as I promised, we'd open this second package after I got home from my ride. Some of you might recognize that logo in the top left corner. I certainly do, so I'm pretty sure I know who this is from. Cool. There's a little note in it here. Happy reading and happy riding. Keep up the great vlogs, Andy. We got a little bit of a care package here from the Roulair magazine. Cheers to Andy from Roulair for sending all this out. We've got a few postcards here. We've got a book here about the cannibal himself, Mr. Eddie Merck, full of pictures and different articles about his time when he was racing. And finally, this special member edition of the Roulair magazine. Yeah, cheers guys, appreciate it. Thank you. Welcome to the evening portion of today's video. We're at Preston Arena and it's time to race.
third again tonight. Pretty hard night's graft. The race pretty much split in half, halfway through. There was about 20 guys started today, and it split into two groups of 10. Thankfully, I was in the front split, and then for the remainder of the race, the last 20, 25 minutes, it was just kind of constant attacks, the usual, ridden into a bunch sprint. Came into the finale, I was positioned, I think, pretty much perfectly, but just didn't have the legs to come around the two crimson lads, and came in third. I'm making a habit of this top three thing. Hopefully that top step isn't too far away. I'll see you in the next one.